For those of you who don't know, I'm Maggie, and today I'm really excited to share with you a bunch of empties. I'm talking like 3 months worth of empties because that's how long it's been since I've done one of these videos. This summer really got away from me, and I feel like it was all for good reason. We finally got to travel and take trips that we've been meaning to take. But now after a good long break, I'm feeling a little bit more creative and excited to share new things. I know that this is a video that I've done a million and one times, but hopefully you'll see some new stuff on the horizon, so stay tuned. But for now, we're gonna dive into this massive box of empties. Also, I feel like I have to say, I parted my hair a little further over, like closer to the middle, and since this hasn't seen daylight in, I don't know, like 10 years, it looks super dark. So I'm kind of like getting used to looking at myself with this part, but what do we think? I kind of like it. All right, this first product is one that I love. I've talked about a million and one times. And if you had been thinking about dipping your toes into the Paula's Choice line of products and you wanted to start with one, this is definitely what I would recommend. I think that my mom introduced me to this product back when I was in the 7th grade, and I'm 29 for perspective. So been using this for quite a while, and I feel like it does make a huge difference in my skin. This is the 2% BHA exfoliant, and I have mine in the gel format, but they do offer this in a liquid. But the reason I always go for the gel is because I feel like it's much easier to apply. You pump it, you just rub it between your fingers and put it on your face. You don't have to bother with cotton pads or any other means necessary to get that liquid onto your face. I suppose you could just douse the liquid in your palms and kind of slap it on your face like a men's aftershave. All in all, I think that the gel is easier to apply. So the reason I like this so much is because all of the claims on the front are exactly what this product accomplishes. It unclogs and shrinks enlarged pores, it smooths an even skin tone, and this is a weightless gel that softens skin. So when I'm not using this, I notice that my pores are a lot more visible, mostly in this area, and I feel like I get a lot more acne prone when I'm not using this. In general, my skin like takes on more of a texture. This will take care of that. If I could only have one Paula's Choice product, this would be the one. Next up, we have these Athena Face Cleansing Makeup Removing Soft Face Wipes. And these were good. I feel like in general, I'm trying to get away from using makeup wipes. And so these did knock things out of the park for me, and I'm not planning to repurchase them. But I will tell you, if you're very loyal to the makeup wipe and you like to use that as maybe a first step in your cleansing process, if you've ever tried Viva paper towels versus like the generic store brand, these feel in texture like Viva paper towels. They're very luxe, soft, cushiony. They seem very strong, like they're not gonna tear easily, and they are just so smooth and soft on your face, which is great. I felt like these could have been a little bit more saturated. I always found myself adding water to them. I feel like when makeup wipes are not very saturated, you do a lot of extra tugging and stuff on your face that's not good for it. That's why I'm a fan of a super saturated face wipe. It makes everything come off so much smoother without a lot of tugging and pulling at your face. So these are not my favorite makeup wipes I've ever tried, but they were good. I really like the texture of them, but everything else was just kind of eh. Oh boy. My favorite dry shampoo. This is the Living Proof Perfect Hair Day Dry Shampoo. I've gone through, six or seven bottles of this stuff in my lifetime, and I really do love it. I think that the Living Proof smell is really good. It kind of makes your 2-day or 3-day greasy hair smell a lot better, kind of like salon smell. But if you don't shake this up adequately before you spray this in your roots, you will end up with a lot of white. And I feel like some people don't like that about this product, but I've found that if you just shake this kind of profusely before you use it, it helps tremendously. So I think that this does a great job of actually making your hair feel cleaner. It really does a good job of soaking up the oils, and you don't have that like shiny, greasy clumps of hair together look after you use this. I have the Macho bottle that I got for a pretty good price during a Living Proof sale that I'm on right now. So I've already repurchased it, if that tells you anything. And this stuff is expensive. Like, I like the Batiste dry shampoo and the Not Your Mother's and some of the others from the drugstore, but I always go back to this one because I do think it's worth the price. Another Paula's Choice product, and this is the Super Light Daily Wrinkle Defense, AKA this is a semi-tinted sunscreen. And I really do love this paired with a moisturizer. I think I've talked about this a number of times too, so I'm not gonna beat a dead horse, but this does have SPF 30. This is my go-to everyday sunscreen Right now I'm using a different one from Paula's Choice that's actually kind of an illuminating one, which I feel like is kind of why you're seeing like the glowiness around, and I really like that one. But this one is said to be more mattifying, which is why I really like to pair it with a moisturizer. I don't think that this can be a one-step sunscreen. Keep that in mind. This is something that I love to use during the hotter months because it does have a little bit of that mattifying quality to it. So when I am oily or hot or sweaty or something, this does a good job of kind of keeping everything at bay. Whereas as we move into the colder months, I prefer to use a more illuminating sunscreen so that I'm getting the sunscreen and a little bit of additional luminosity when my skin is on the drier side. If you're somebody that never changes up your products from season to season and you constantly struggle with dry, flaky skin in the fall and the winter, really consider changing things up. I already have another bottle of this, so if you were wondering if I would repurchase, 1000% I already have. And I think this is my third full bottle to go through, and I'm on my fourth. Oh boy, this is really kind of embarrassing because if you've been watching me for a little while, then you'll know that this came in a summer FabFitFun box probably 2 years ago. I got to the point where I had used up most of it, and you can see there's still a little bit left. I couldn't bring myself to put it on my body and let my body soak up this two-year-old lotion. However, it does still smell amazing. This smells very like vanilla-y, tropical-y, coconut-y kind of smell that I really love in the summertime, but I feel like I don't want my whole body to smell like this. I even liked the smell so much and convinced myself that I did want my body to smell like that I bought the body spray that just smells like this and never used it. Never touched it. I went to my like springy, florally, fresh perfumes over that body spray every single time. So now that I finally figured that out about myself, I don't see myself repurchasing this, but this is a really, really good lotion. Now that we're entering kind of the Christmas season in a couple of months, they have these really good gift sets that have these in little sizes. So that could be a good stocking stuffer or like gift for a friend since this stuff is crazy expensive. And if they really like that scent, that could be a good idea. Pronamel Sensodyne, my favorite toothpaste ever because I have the world's most sensitive teeth. And if you have really sensitive teeth and you've been putting off buying something like this because you think it's gimmicky, look no further. This stuff really, really works. I've also found, I'm not out of these yet, but some really good whitening strips that don't leave your gums and your teeth super sensitive. So I'll be sure to link those. I've talked about this 900 times, so again, don't wanna bore you with it, but this is great. Gentle whitening toothpaste for sensitive teeth people. A product I don't like, unfortunately, and this comes from Origins, and it's the Ginseng SPF 40 Energy Boosting Tinted Moisturizer. This stuff makes your skin orange. Like, I don't know what skin tone this is trying to match, but it is a wild color, and this stuff breaks apart on your skin so easily. This is just, to me, not a very reliable tinted moisturizer. It moves around so much. It looks patchy by the end of the day, and it gives you kind of an orange hue that just cannot be flattering on anybody. So if you like this and you figured out how to make it work, I would love for you to let me know because I feel like this little sample thing comes in so many Origins gift sets that I always end up with them and I try them and every single time it lets me down. I did find that setting it with the powder kind of helps a little bit more, but I would not recommend this. There are a million other tinted moisturizers or BB creams or CC creams on the market that are better than this. Another hair product. This is the Kristen S. Signature Finishing Hairspray. You can get this stuff at Target. I really like this line. I think it looks super high-end, but it's also at a super accessible price point. It's not the cheapest in the store, but it's also not Sephora prices. So I feel like if you're looking for something that's a little step up, then Kristen S. is for you. However, this is the second time that this hairspray has pooped out on me because of the nozzle. Like, of course, now it's gonna work, kinda. Did you see how weird that was? I'm saying every other time that I went to go use this, the nozzle just wouldn't press down. I would shake it, I would press the nozzle down, it would be completely stuck. I would be bearing all of my body weight on it, nothing, wouldn't budge. Then the next time I pick it up, it works fine. So, I mean, now that it's spraying, maybe I need to keep it. I have probably like this much left of it. This is not the first time that I've had this issue with their hairspray and I gave it a second shot and here we are again. Is this just me? Has anybody else had this problem? I feel like their dry shampoo works fine. I love their shampoo and conditioner, but this, while I love the hold of this hairspray and the smell, and I think it works really well, I can't get it out of the bottle half the time. I feel like the hairspray is an exception in their line. Like everything else has been really great that I've tried. We have another moisturizer that I got in a FabFitFun box a couple of seasons ago, and I believe I got this as an add-on. This is the Ole Henriksen Sea Rush Brightening Double Cream. This is the only thicker cream-based daytime moisturizer that I like, I've decided. I typically go for more gel-based or just much lighter day creams than I do in the nighttime. In the nighttime, I want that ultra moisture. I want to wake up with my skin really plump and healthy looking. But in the day, I can get overly greasy if I don't watch out. The smell of this is Fruity Pebbles, straight up. Open a box of Fruity Pebbles. That's exactly what this moisturizer smells like. It's kind of a light orange hue when the entire tub is full. And this lasts a really long time because a little bit goes a long way because it is on the thicker side, but it sinks into your skin so nicely that it doesn't feel like you're wearing a mask when you're outside sweating in the summer. I hate that feeling of having just too much on your face, which is why this summer, legitimately, I have not put on BB cream, CC cream, foundation, nothing. I've found that I like to let my skin breathe in the summer. I'm so sad to be out of this because it is kind of pricey. I think this is like $36 at Sephora, but so worth it. I love going between this and the Origins Ginseng Daytime, like the gel moisturizer. Talk about a pricey product. So I was just like, oh, that one's $36 and it's just a pain to buy. This one is like $99. And this is not a joke. This was another product that I got an add-on or a box boost or something like that through FabFitFun and ended up getting this for super cheap. I wanna say, well, relatively speaking, I wanna say I got this for like $15 or $20 or something like that. This is the Pericone MD Rejuvenating Moisturizer. This is supposed to be a great nighttime moisturizer. I wiped this puppy clean. I was not leaving a single bit of this product behind because it was so expensive. And this is luxurious, y'all. Like, this is a great nighttime moisturizer. I loved it while I had it, but I could never fork over $100 to have this again. Like, that was a nice treat. Glad I experienced that in my life. But maybe if you are into really investing in your skincare and you've been on the lookout for something that's definitely gonna rise to the occasion and really be worth the price, this one is definitely that. I felt a difference in my skin when I woke up in the morning. It was so soft. It looked so smooth and radiant. I love this, but I couldn't pull the trigger on the full price. I really couldn't. You've heard me talk about this one a time or two. We are out of another L'Oreal Lash Paradise. This is the voluminous version, and this is not waterproof. This is just their regular. It has a really thick brush that does a great job of actually volumizing your lashes. The issue with this for me is that this did transfer a bit on my upper lashes. Like, over time, I don't know if the formula changed or maybe my lashes have grown or something is happening, but this did start to transfer a little bit and is drying out so quickly. Like, I've said this before, this is nothing new. I feel like a million people have said this, but these truly only last like a month to a month and a half, and then you're kind of out. And at $10 a piece, like, that adds up over a year. So I have tried out some new mascaras. I'll be sure to talk about those. I have one that is definitely going into a monthly favorites video here in a few weeks, I guess, because it is so good. It's what I'm wearing today, and I've had multiple people comment on my lashes since wearing that mascara. I was very flattered. So if you're curious, stay tuned. That will definitely be in a favorites video, but that's not to say I wouldn't repurchase this. I totally would. I've gone through like, I don't know, 8 or 9 tubes of this, but I wanted to kind of branch out, try something new that could be working for me a little bit better, and I think I found it. The Dermalogica Special Cleansing Gel. This is something that I've wanted to try for years. I feel like there are people that swear by this stuff. It's a really no frills line. Like, there's no fragrance. Like, even the branding is kind of boring. Like, there's just really nothing to it. But I've heard that this cleanser is just outstanding and that it does a great job of removing makeup and it does a great job of cleaning your face. But I just really didn't feel like this was anything to write home about. So in the end, I'm really thankful that I ended up trying this just in a trial size rather than buying the full bottle, because I'm a very loyal Paula's Choice cleanser person and I truly don't think there's anything better on the market. So if you're looking for a cleanser that's actually gonna remove your makeup and leave your skin feeling soft and not dried out, be really gentle, it has no fragrances. Like, there are a million different types of face washes on their website that all perform wonderfully, and this just wasn't as good. So that might be a hot take because I feel like a lot of people like this, but I will not be repurchasing this and not even giving it a second thought because my Paula's Choice cleansers are better. Man, This Dr. Teal's Pure Epsom Salt Melatonin Sleep Soak is the best smelling bath salts on the market, in my opinion. These are so affordable. This entire bag, which is 3 pounds, is like $5. And the scent on this is the most relaxing. It's lavender and chamomile, and it really permeates the bathroom, and the scent lingers for a little while. So you just, it creates an experience more than just like a really soft bath soak, if that makes sense. And I think the scent is what I love most about this. There are a million different scents from the Dr. Teal's line, and they have a lot of good ones, which is why I think it's saying a lot that I think this one is my favorite. I was gifted this once, but this is the second 3 pound bag that I've been through. I really took a big hiatus on summer baths because I don't want to exit like 110 degree heat to go sit in a warm bath. So I'll probably be repurchasing this soon in the fall and winter months when you want to get into a warm bath. All right, last but certainly not least is this Living Proof Restore Repair Leave-In. This is just a spray-on leave-in conditioner. So how I use this is I get out of the shower, I let my hair dry in its little towel for a little bit, take it down, and I spray this in my hair before I brush it out. This helps eliminate breakage. It makes it really easy to move that brush through your hair, and overall just makes it look shinier and healthier the next day. I think the top question that I get asked about when I do videos like this is like, what is your hair care routine? Like, your hair looks great, looks healthy. My big secret, which is not that big of a secret, is just to be really diligent about using leave-in conditioners before you're brushing through wet hair. Brushing through wet hair can really damage it. You need to start at the bottoms and be really diligent about how you move that brush through your hair, because you can end up with that like crown of breakage at the top, which I sometimes struggle with. And I also barely ever use heat tools. I picked up my blow dryer today for the first time in probably 2 or 3 months. And so I think just giving it a break, letting it breathe, treating it well, that's how you can keep your hair healthy. But this stuff I really like. I really went on a tangent there. It has a really good little pump. So I typically do 2 pumps in my hand, sometimes 3, depending on how long my hair is at the time. And just put it in from about like my ear level down. I don't put it on my roots because my hair can get greasy really fast, so it wouldn't be great near my scalp, but this is something that I will totally repurchase when I run out of the one that I have now. This was a long one. I feel like that was a lot of products that have been on backlog since I haven't done one of these videos in a while, but that was really fun. This is one of my favorite videos to film because I feel like I have truly formed opinions on all of these products. So if you've tried anything out new in the past month or run out of a product that you want to just, I don't know, shout from the rooftops about, leave it in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you're using. Maybe try to explore some new products myself. So if you like this video, then like it. Stick around, subscribe, join the community, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.